Welcome. Today we are going to start the demonstration of experiment number 6, which is nodal slide, and it is as per the physics lab KS201P. Now in this particular experiment we are covering the course outcome, which is to relate physical optics with nodal slide assembly and optical fiber setup, and it is the CO number 4 of physics KS201 lab. The aim of the experiment is to determine the focal length of combination of two thin convergent lenses separated by a distance with the help of a nodal slide assembly, and to verify the formula, which is 1 by capital F is equals to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2 minus X upon F1 F2, where capital F represents the combined focal length of the lens system, and F1 and F2 represents the individual focal length of the two given lenses, and X is the separation which is placed in between the two lenses to find out the different focal length combination. In addition to this, you have to find out the cardinal points of that particular system, where cardinal points are basically 6 in number: 2 focal points, 2 nodal points and 2 principal points. Now nodal points in this particular system corresponds to those points where angular magnification is unity, and principal point corresponds to those particular cardinal points where the linear magnification is 1. Now, in this particular setup, we require a nodal slide assembly, an optical bench, a plane mirror, a cross slit, a lamp, and two given lenses. And we can easily identify these particular parts in this particular setup. This one is the light source, which is basically nothing. It is a tungsten bulb, which is placed inside this bulb holder. And with the help of this particular bulb, you can pass light through this particular slit. This is the second component of this particular setup, which is in the form of cross slit. And this particular cross slit then passes the light through this nodal slide assembly, which consists of two holders, where we can mount the two different lenses on this particular system. And finally, the part of this particular system is basically the plane mirror. The plane mirror is basically used to reflect the light back to the system, so that image can be obtained on the screen to find the exact focal length in this particular case. So in this particular case, there is one lamp, and then followed by a cross slit, then a nodal slide assembly, and then a mirror. And this whole arrangement is basically is mounted on an optical bench, which is approximately 1.5 meter length. So there are four uprights in this particular experiment, and these four uprights are mounted on an optical bench. And this carriage, special carriage, which can host up to two lenses on this particular platform, is basically termed as a nodal slide assembly. So in this particular experiment, we are basically using this particular assembly to find out the focal length of a combined lens system, and then to find out the cardinal points of that particular given system. Now this is basically termed as nodal slide, and we know that the focal length of a lens system is the distance between its principal point and the corresponding focal point. The principal point coincides with the corresponding nodal points when the media are of the same or both the sides of the system are air. Thus, the focal length of the system can be found by locating a nodal point and the corresponding focal point. But in the case of a lens system, there can be different focal points, different principal points and different nodal points, and this is our aim to find the 6 combinations of these particular points, and they are termed as cardinal points, where the principal points corresponds to linear magnification of 1 and the nodal points corresponds to angular magnification of 1. So this theory is basically given in this particular lab manual, where you can go through this particular lab manual and to find out the positions of the nodal point and the principal point. But practically, we have to first set this particular experiment and then take the focal length of individual lenses. So whenever we are taking the observations, we are basically moving towards the first part, which is to find the focal length of the first lens in this particular experiment. And to perform this particular experiment, you need two different convex lenses, and with the help of these two convex lenses, you can find out the focal length of individual lenses. So in this particular experiment, this is the light source, which is basically illuminating a cross slit, and the cross slit is basically passing the light in the form of a plus shape. This plus shape light is then followed by a nodal slide assembly, where we can mount different lenses. And then there is a plane mirror, and this whole assembly is mounted on an optical bench, which is approximately 1.5 meter length. So there are total 4 uprights, and this is basically termed as the nodal slide assembly, and this nodal side assembly is basically mounted on a particular stand which can rotate about its axis, and then there are multiple devices attached to this particular assembly. The first one is the marker, where you can see that there is a scale on this particular nodal side assembly, and then there is a plastic strip in which a observation mark is mounted, and then this is basically aligned with the bottom side of this optical bench, where the sign will finally provide you the position of the upright on the with respect to the optical bench. So the readings can be obtained with the help of this meter scale, which is attached with this particular optical bench at the lower end. So now this one is basically a plane mirror. This mirror is basically used to reflect the light which is coming parallel to this particular lens system, and then this particular light can be passed again with the help of this nodal side assembly to get the desired image. So there are multiple lens holders, there are two in number, and you can easily rotate this particular lens system so that you can find out the. Now you have to take two different convex lenses, and these particular convex lenses are basically of different focal length. So we are taking two different lenses and then mounting these particular lenses in this particular figure. So here you can see that we are using this particular lens system, and then there is a mark on this particular lens holder where you can find the location of that particular lens. So we can mount the first lens on any one of the holders, and then with the help of this particular system we can easily find the location of this particular object with the help of these two markers which are marked on this particular lens system. Initially you have to adjust this particular position of this particular lens so that your lens will be exactly on the zero of that particular scale. So you have to first make sure that the lens mark, which is basically parked on the upper part of this particular moving part, and then you have to align this particular mirror lens on this particular zero mark. Then once you adjust the position of this particular nodal side assembly, you will find out that you will observe a cross sign which is basically again forming on the same cross slit frame, and this is basically due to the light which is passing through this slit, then it finally passes through the lens system, and after passing through the lens system it falls on the mirror which is attached on the last part. And because the plane mirror always reflect the light back to the system, this particular light when coming back to the lens system will again make an image on the slit. And we can use the property of this particular system such that if your lens is exactly at the focal point of this cross slit, or the cross slit is basically exactly on the focal point of the lens system, then your light after passing through the lens system will become parallel, and this particular parallel light will be reflected back to the system. So again you are observing a clear image on the focal plane, which is basically the black sheet of this particular cross slit. So the only method of taking the focal length is creating a plus sign again on the black sheet so that you can find out the focal length. But initially you have to adjust this particular lens system in such a way that the zero of this particular system will be aligned with the plastic arrangement which is attached here on, and then you have to adjust this particular second system such that you will get a clear and a bright image of that particular cross slit. Once both these readings are obtained, when the setup is in this exact condition, then you can take the readings for the table 1 with the help of the bottom scale which is attached with this optical bench. So in this particular case you have to take the reading for one side of the lens, and then you have to rotate it on the other side so that both the readings of the first side and the second sides can be taken simultaneously, and the readings of this particular values can be again noted down in both table 1 and table 2. Here table 1 and table 2 is nothing, it is basically representing the tables for recording the focal length for lens 1 and lens 2. So now we have adjusted this particular lens and then we have noted down both these particular values of table 1 and table 2. We can simultaneously apply two different lenses on this particular nodal slide assembly, and with the help of these two particular lenses you can find that again the images are formed on this particular cross slit. But now you are observing more than one image which is formed on this particular scale, and then there will be a doubt whether which one is the real image. Now because you are using a lens system, the lens has the property of reflecting the light from the front surface, so there may be a possibility that one of the images is obtained due to the reflection from the front surface and it is not due to the reflection through the mirror. So you have to check whether the image formed on the screen is basically due to the image which is getting reflected from the mirror or it is directly reflected from the lens system. So for this particular purpose, what we can do is we can just make sure that the image which is basically creating a doubt in our mind will get disappeared once we cover the mirror, so that none of the light will get reflected back to this particular system. So in this particular case, we will first try to check which one of the image is basically the real image, because we are getting more than one image in this particular case. So the second part is just block this particular light which is basically coming through this particular mirror, and then you will observe that the light which is the image which disappears due to this particular placement of the hand in front of the mirror is the real image which we want to focus on. So now both the lenses are mounted, we are getting clear image on the sheet. Then we will note down the corresponding values, but because we are using a lens system, what we can do is we have to eliminate the lateral shift in this particular case, where lateral shift is basically the movement of this particular image by displacing the nodal slide assembly by an amount of 0 to 5 degrees. So when you rotate this particular nodal slide assembly by an amount of 0 to 5 degrees, you will observe that your image will be slightly moving left or right, and you have to eliminate this particular lateral displacement by adjusting the positions of the lenses on the nodal slide assembly, which can be done by moving the knob which is placed on the nodal slide assembly, so that whole of the lens system will move either forward or backward. Now once the lens system is in forward direction, then you have to take the whole assembly into the backward direction, or once the lenses will go in the backward direction, then you have to take the assembly in the forward direction. So by adjusting this particular setup, you will observe that finally you will get a clear image which is free from lateral inversion, and then you have to find the second phase readings also, so you can finally rotate this particular system and get the desired answer. So this is what we normally do in this particular setup. You have to find a position where you are getting a clear image on this particular slit, and then by taking the reading from the bottom optical bench, you can find out the positions of the nodal slide focal length of this particular lens with the help of the nodal slide system. Now after taking this particular reading, you have to fill the readings on this particular table. The first table is basically for the observation of the focal length of the first lens. You can place your cross slit at any desired position. Then you have to put one lens on this particular system, and this particular lens will be basically adjusted such that you are getting a clear image of plus sign on this particular focal plane of the cross slit, and both the positions of the cross slit and the positions of the lens system will be noted from the optical bench, and the difference of this without sign is taken as the focal length. Then after rotating the whole apparatus by an amount of 180 degrees, you can get the reading for the other face, and then you can find out the focal length of the other lens also. You have to repeat this particular experiment for different values of positions of the cross slit. So you can repeat this particular experiment once more for a different value of position of cross slit, and then get two more readings for the focal length. Because the focal length of a system is basically fixed, so all these four readings are nearly equal, and you can take the average of all these four readings to get the desired value of focal length of the first lens. Now, once you get the focal length of the first lens, you can move to the second lens. You can now replace the first lens with your second lens, then readjust the positions of the crosslet, and then find out the focal length of the second lens. Again, you have to take four different readings, and then you have to take the average of the four readings to get the value of the focal length of this particular lens. In the second part, you have to find a combined focal length. In this particular case, you have to mount two different lenses, where the two different lenses are placed at two different distances. The first distance that we take in laboratory is the 6 cm distance, and the second one is the 8 cm distance. So in this table, there are two columns. Column number one, row number one is for the 6 cm distance, and row number two is for the 8 cm distance. Again, there is the same procedure. You have to find out a position where you are getting a clear image of the plus sign. And then you have to find a better position so that there is no little shift in this particular image. And then after getting the desired location, you have to find the difference between the two positions of the crosslet and the nodal side assembly. You have to take the second observation by rotating the system by an amount of 180 degree. And then you have to find the second value of the focal length, which is nearly equal. And then you can take the average of these two readings to get the first focal length of the combined system when the value of separation between the two lenses is 6 cm. Then you have to perform the same experiment for different values of focal length separation, which is 8 cm, and get the desired value of f2. Now, with the help of, because we know the value of focal length of lens 1, focal length of lens 2, we know the value of d, which is 6 in the first case and 8 in the second case, you can find out the theoretical values of capital F in this particular case. And by comparing the theoretical value of capital F with the practical value which we are obtaining in this particular column number 1, row number 1, we can find out the error in this particular experiment. So you have to find theoretically what is the required value of observed value of this focal length for 6 cm and 8 cm, and compare it with the practical values. Now, because we are also observing the cardinal points in this particular case, so first principal point location can be obtained by using this particular formula. And the second principal point is basically obtained by using the second formula. And the principal points are nothing, they are points on the principal axis where the linear magnification of that particular image is 1. And the first focal point and second focal point can also be obtained by this particular method. So in this particular experiment, we are basically finding the focal length of a combined lens system and verifying the formula 1 by capital F is equals to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. And while doing this particular experiment, you have to take certain precautions which are mentioned here. So false images obtained by partial reflection from the faces can be eliminated, which I have already shown, by covering the lens mirror with the help of your hand or with the help of some other blocking material. You can find the image which disappears once you block this particular mirror. So then in the next part, you have to concentrate on that particular image which has disappeared. So, because you know that this particular image is basically formed by two reflections from the mirror. While determining the focal length of a single lens, the optical center must lie on the exact axis of rotation of the nodal side for easy and quick setting. That's why we have basically mounted the first lens on the nodal side assembly. Then the zero of that particular nodal side assembly will be exactly coinciding with the lens marking point, so that my axis of rotation will be exactly passing through the axis of rotation of the nodal side assembly. So these are the one of few of the precautions which you can take while taking this particular experiment, and then calculate the focal length of a combined system. Thank you.